Guys, I hope you're able to hear me, right?
Yes, sir.
Let's get started. So in EMI, we have seen self-inductance and mutual inductance also. Right, and we were doing some problems, right? We'll do a few more problems, then we will go to the next topic. So this we have completed yesterday. Right, we'll do the fifth one now. So let's try this out. There are two long coaxial solenoids of same length L. The inner and the outer coils have radii R1 and R2, and the number of turns per unit length are N1 and N2 respectively. The ratio of mutual inductance to the self-inductance of the inner coil is how much? Try this out.
Sir, option B, sir.
Good, Mushanda. Option
B, sir.
B. Idhuva. So let me check. ஆப்ஷன் டி இல்ல சி கொடுத்துருக்கா செக் நோ வாட் மிஸ்டேக் யூ டிட் டிம் கொடுத்துருக்கு லெட்ஸ் ட்ரை திஸ் So what is the mutual inductance of the inner coil? It is mu naught N1 N2 into, what is the formula? Area, right? Mu naught N1 N2 into A into L. So pi R1 square into L. So, what is the self inductance of the inner coil? It is mu naught N1 square pi R1 square into L. So ratio of the mutual inductance to the self-inductance means mu naught cancel, pi R1 square L cancel, N2 cancels. So what is that we are left out with? Oh, sorry, N2.
N1 cancels.
Sorry, yeah. N1 gets cancelled, up N2 by N1 is the answer.
Mutual inductance in R2 square, no potential, sorry.
Of course, area of that coil will come into consideration. Correct? So, Epame, one important thing, I'll show you something. Whether you write M21 or M12, it is always the radius of the inner coil that comes into picture. Smaller coil eduvo adoda area da varum adha nyabu vechukko, that is a thumb rule. So whether it is M21 or M12 enga irukku M12 la kuda pathina pi R1 square da varum, okay va? So it is always the area of the smaller coil, that is a thumb rule when you apply the concept of mutual inductance between a bigger coil and a smaller coil. Sariya?
Yes, sir.
So sixth one is very easy. The two circular coils are arranged in any of the three situations shown in the figure. Their mutual inductance will be maximum in situation A, maximum in B, maximum in C, same in all the cases. So answer in it. This coil number 1, coil number 2, 1, 2, 1, 2.
Maximum in A, sir.
Yes, that is the answer. Because obviously more flux will be linked with the second coil. That's it. That's the logic. Okay. அடுத்தது வந்து the LR circuits and all we will see after going to the alternating current sorter. Where is that? Alternating current based problems. So alternating current, what do we get from the generator? E is equal to E naught sine omega t, which is a base for the next chapter that we know, right? So look at the first question. There is a circuit. So here also the R and C are involved. Okay, let's do the second one. So there is an alternating voltage of 220 sine pi, 100 pi t volt, which is applied to a purely resistive load of 50 ohm. The time taken for the current to rise from half to peak of half of the peak value to the peak value. Guys, just give me 2 minutes time, okay? One our document ready panita, I'll show it to you. Just give me 2 minutes time. We'll start alternating currents actually. Yeah. Now we'll see some concepts of alternating current. Then we'll solve those problems. So alternating current, you guys know the equation, right? The equation for EMF is E is equal to E naught sine omega t. And the equation for current is I is equal to I naught sine omega t. Then we have a concept of mean value and RMS value of alternating current. So what does mean value mean? So the mean value of an alternating current over half a cycle. So mean values, if you observe, the average values are not calculated over the complete cycle, because when you try to calculate it over complete cycle, the average comes out to be zero. So the mean value of alternating current over half a cycle is a finite quantity, and in fact, it is a quantity which is defined as the mean value of alternating current. So what is its value? It is 1 by T by 2 into integral of I dt from 0 to pi by 2. So I hope you know this, right? So average means what? Sum of all the values divided by the total value. So integral of I dt, see, alternating current is like this. So if you want to calculate for half the time period, then you will consider a small element here. So integral of I dt from 0 to T by 2, the whole divided by integral of T, whole divided by T by 2. If you calculate its value, it will come out as 2 I naught by pi, which is 0.637 times I naught. Right? Similarly, mean or average value in the next half cycle is going to be what? It will be negative of that value, minus 2 I naught divided by pi, which is minus 0.637 times I naught. Okay? Whereas when you try to calculate it for the complete cycle, this value plus this value will get added and it gives a zero. Similarly, if you want to calculate the RMS value of alternating voltage, it also comes out to be 0.637 times V naught, right? Similarly, how do you calculate the root mean square value? So root mean square value means square root of the average of current over a complete cycle divided by T. Here it will not become zero because you're doing I square. When you do I square, you get sine square. Sine square over zero to T is not zero. Right. So, and its value comes out to be I naught divided by root 2, which is 0.707 times I naught. Okay. Next. So, we have the concept of reactance. So, reactance is applicable for what kind of devices? It is applicable for inductors and capacitors. So, the opposition offered by an inductor or a capacitor in the path of flow of alternating current is called reactance. So, what are the two types of reactances you have? You have inductive reactance, which is given by the formula XL is equal to 2 pi F into L, or you have capacitive reactance, which is given as XC is equal to 1 by omega C, right? So XL is observed to be directly proportional to F, and the value for direct current XL is zero, means an inductor will allow the direct current to flow through it, but it will oppose the alternating current. That is the meaning, okay? So have this point in your mind. Similarly, what will a capacitor do? This I've told you in current electricity when we solve problems based on R and C. right? So when R and C circuits are being used, capacitive reactance, the resistance offered by a capacitor, and its value is given as 1 by omega C or 1 by 2 pi into F into C. Correct? And it is inversely proportional to F. With respect to direct current, the resistance, the reactance offered by a capacitor is infinite. Means it will not allow DC to pass through it, rather it will allow only AC to pass through it. Okay. Next is, what is impedance? Impedance is the opposition offered by an alternating current circuit containing more than one out of the three components L, C and R. Okay. And its value is generally given as Z is equal to root of R square plus XL minus XC the whole square. If it is an RLC circuit, suppose it is an RL circuit, you will have root of R square plus XL square. If it is only RC circuit, you will have root of R square plus XC square. Right. Then, how do you calculate the power in an alternating current AC circuit? This is very, very important. Okay. With respect to JEE, the problems will be based on this. So how do you define the power as? The power as the rate at which the work is being done. The average power in an AC circuit is given by this formula. P average is equal to V RMS into I RMS multiplied with cos theta, or some books refer it as phi, where the cos of phi is what is called as the power factor of the AC circuit. Okay. So VRMS, it is V by root 2. IRMS is I by root 2 into cos phi. So V into I divided by 2 into cos phi is what is the average power in an AC circuit. If it is a DC circuit, you just multiply V and I. DC voltage multiplied with DC current. Okay. So cos phi also has a formula which is given by the equation resistance divided by impedance. It is the ratio of the resistance to the impedance offered by the circuit. Guys, clear till this step? Is there any doubt?
No, sir.
What else?
Okay. Next is the relation between current and potential for different alternating current circuits. So if it is a pure resistive circuit, we call it as R circuit, then it is understood that the current and the voltage are in the same phase, right? So alternating current will be E naught sine omega t, alternating current will be I naught sine omega t, then alternating EMF and alternating current both are in the same phase. Then you have the average power in this case as EV into IV, or I can write it as V RMS into I RMS. Cos phi is 1. Why? Because the value of phi is how much?
0.
They're in the same phase, 0 degrees. So power factor in a purely resistive circuit is 1. So sometimes what they can do in the question is, they can say it like this. The alternating source is connected across a device such that the EMF and the alternating current are in the same phase. Then you should understand it's a resistor. Okay. Similarly, if you talk about a purely inductive circuit, then what will happen? Alternating current is E naught sine omega t. Alternating EMF is E naught sine omega t. Alternating current is I naught sine of omega t minus pi by 2. What is the meaning of this? In this case, the alternating current lags behind the EMF by an angle of pi by 2. Okay. So inductive reactance, everything we have discussed. The average power when you try to calculate here is 0, because the value of phi is how much? Pi by 2. Similarly, the power factor is 0. Next. If it is a pure capacitive circuit, then what will happen is current will lead the voltage by how much? Pi by 2. So that is why you will have I is equal to I naught sine of omega t plus pi by 2. This is the value. So capacitive reactance is given by 2 pi into F into C, and here it is omega into C. So what is the average power here? Also 0. The power factor is 0. Now comes the RC circuit. So when you talk about an RC circuit, what will happen? So if you take, this is the voltage across the resistor, then current across the resistor will also be in the same direction, because with respect to a resistor, voltage and current are in the same phase. So when R and C are connected in series, what parameter out of potential and current will be the same?
Current, sir.
So current will be same. So with respect to a capacitor, how is the current with respect to voltage? Current is leading the voltage. So current is here means voltage across the capacitor will be lagging by pi pi. You're able to understand. So the resultant of these two is what is going to be here, which is V. Then what is the value of V dump? V is root of Vc square plus Vr square if you use the phasor diagram. Right? Similarly, V is written as I into Z is equal to root of I square into XC square plus I square into R square. I square, I is gone. Z is equal to root of R square plus XC square, that is 1 by omega C the whole square. Similarly, what is tan phi? Tan phi is equal to Vc divided by Vr. Vc alone, I into R. This is I into XC, cancel. So R divided by 1 by omega C. Okay. Actually, it should be 1 by omega CR. That's the meaning. So if it comes down, it will be 1 by omega CR. So if they ask you the phase difference, this is the formula that you are going to use. Similarly, when you talk about an LC circuit, what is going to happen? So with respect to an LC circuit, E is equal to E naught sine omega t. Alternating current, I is equal to I naught sine omega t minus phi. Okay. So impedance will be what? It will be the difference of XL and XC. It can either be XL minus XC or XC minus XL. Then what is the value of tan phi, guys? It will be XL minus XC divided by 0. Okay. If the value of XL is greater than XC, then the value of phi that you can use here is pi by 2. If XL is less than XC, then the value of phi that you can use is minus pi by 2. If XL is equal to XC, then what is this condition called?
Resonance.
Yes. So this is what we call it as the resonance voltage. At that, in that case, what will happen is the impedance will be impedance of this circuit, not the RLC circuit. Okay. Similarly, if it is an LCR circuit, what is going to happen? E naught sine omega t, alternating current will be I naught sine omega t plus or minus phi, because that depends on whether XL is greater than XC or XC is greater than XL. So alternating current lags behind the alternating EMF by phi. Okay. Suppose I try to draw the phasor diagram. If this is taken as VR, then IR will also be in the same direction. So with respect to current, the voltage in the capacitor lags. The voltage in the inductor leads. If VL is greater than VC, then VC will go to the other side such that you become VC with a negative sign. So what is the final diagram you will have? You will have VL minus VC and you will have this as VR and the resultant will be V. So V will be equal to root of VR square plus VL minus VC the whole square. So that is root of R square plus XL minus XC the whole square. So this is the impedance. Power factor, we know it is defined as resistance divided by the impedance. R divided by impedance is root of R square plus XL minus XC the whole square. So average power delay will be how much? It will be EV into IV into cos phi. Okay. So till the concepts discussed till now, we will try out some problems from alternating current. I think we can start with the first problem itself. So a circuit is connected to an AC source of EMF E naught sine 100 pi t, where t is in seconds, given a phase difference of pi by 4 between the EMF and the current. Which of the following circuits will exhibit this? So how to do? How to do that? So with the help of phase difference, what formula can we actually use?
Tan phi.
Yes. But since here, anything is possible. So what is tan phi? Just give me a minute. So tan phi it can either be an RC circuit or RL circuit according to the options. Correct? So it can either be XL divided by R or XC divided by R. We have to take all the values, substitute and see, no other option. So omega value. Omega on the 100. 100. Radians per second. Now let's try this out. So tan pi by 4 is 1 is equal to XL. It is omega into L divided by R. So try it out with the second and the fourth option. Omega. So omega is 10 square. L. 1 millihenry. R. 1 kilo ohm. So B is not satisfying. Similarly, C, 10 square into 10 into 10 power minus 3, the whole divided by 10 cube. Not satisfying. RC, 1 by omega CR is should be coming out as 1. 1 by omega is 100 into C is how much? 10 power minus 6 into this is 10 power 3. So 100 into 10 power 3, 10 power 5. So I think the first option. So first option is the answer. Guys, I hope you understood.
Yes, sir.
So no other option. You have to use trial and error method. Next. So there is an alternating voltage which is given by the value 220 sine 100 pi t is applied to a purely resistive load of 50 ohm. The time taken for the current to rise from half of the peak value to the peak value. So V, how to find out the value of I? Since V of t is given as 220 sine 100 pi into t, what will be I of theta? It will be 220 divided by 5 into sine of 100 pi into t. How much is this? 45? 50, rather. Four point four. Or we'll leave it as 220 by 50 and see if something gets cancelled. 100 pi into t. Okay, this is now on the equation one at the graph. This is I of t. The time taken for the electric current to raise from half of the peak value to its peak value. Let's see. We have to think in terms of when it will reach the peak value. Half of its peak value. So when will it go to one of the extremes? You recollect the simple harmonic motion because this is the equation of simple harmonic motion. When will the particle be at its extreme position for the first time?
Half time, sir.
Let up. Is
zero. Well, 1/4, sir.
It will be at T by 4. So this is the I max. This is the maximum value of current at T is equal to T by 4. When is it going to be the time taken for the current to raise from half of the peak value to the peak value? When is it going to be at half of the peak value?
T by 8.
T by 8 kadaiyadu, exact half kadaiyadu. So if I want to I max I max by 2 nadukrana, then what I need to do is I need to substitute the instantaneous value and see I max by 2 is equal to I max times sine of 100 pi into T. And the T, let me call it as T1. So, idu cancel it. So, sine of 100 pi T1 is equal to sine theta is equal to pi by 3, pi by 6. Puri dadana panana. Sine theta is equal to half for this. Since I'm in the first quadrant, I took it as pi by 6. So, what is the value of T1? Is it not 1 by 600? It is 1 by 600 of a second. And T2 evlo time period divided by 4 time period order time period is equal to 2 pi by omega. So 2 pi divided by 100 pi cancel, it is 1 by 50. So T2 is 1 by 200 seconds. So T2 minus T1 evlo, is it not 1 by 200 minus 1 by 600 that it be 400 divided by 1200 cancel. So 1 divided by 3 is 0.33. So 12,000 Celsius. One by 13. 0.0033. That is the option required. 3.3. Guys, did you understand what I did? Yeah. In the point, Purila. See, V of T Kudurka. I found I of T. So that is 220 divided by 50 times this value. The question is, what is the time taken for the current to rise from half of the peak value? So peak value on the I naught Nedu, but I max would. I naught Nedu, peak value. Okay. First time, when will it reach I naught? See, in the sine omega t, you can always take the help of simple harmonic motion. Or a particle every poi extreme position, current. So the current is going to reach its maximum value for the first time at 1/4 of the time period. And the concept for it.
Yes.
When will it reach the maximum? When will it reach half of the maximum value of current? That is what we need to know. If I take this as T, that T is what I found it to be 1 by 600 of a second. So, in here, 1 by 600 seconds. Upper T by 4, I would T contribution, I need 2 pi by omega. 2 pi by omega gave me 1 by 50. So, 1 by 50, na, T by 4 will be 1 by 200. Upper either end, what is the time difference? Is it not 1 by 200 minus 1 by 600?
Yes.
So that is the amount of time it took for the particle to, for the current to go from half to max. Purita, I hope others are also clear. let's try this out. So there is a capacitor. I think some data is missing. I2. So there is a capacitor, resistor, current of I2 inductor and R1. In the above circuit, C is root 3 by 2 times mu f, R2 is 20 ohm, L is root 3 by 10 Henry and R1 is 10 ohm. Current in the LR path is I1 and CR2 path is I2. The voltage of AC source is connected. Then we need to find the phase difference between I1 and I2. So Malar, if you observe, A and B is an RC circuit and C and D is an RL circuit. Both are connected in what way, what manner? Both are connected in what manner? They are in parallel. So parallel irukna, then I can take this as a separate circuit and here the current will be I2. I can take this as a separate circuit and the current here will be I1. Purida? Ipa, what are they asking? They want the phase difference between these currents. Are they able to figure? So this is L, this is R2, this is I1. Okay. So here voltage is same, here voltage is same. Now my question is, we need the reference of voltage because the voltage is the one which is same in both the conductors, right? I mean both the circuits. Now listen, tan, if I take this as the first circuit and second circuit, what is tan phi 1? So tan phi 1 is the phase difference between current and voltage in this circuit. So tan phi 1, 1 by omega c r 2 r, 1 by omega yolo. So 2 phi omega on the 100 r. Omega is 100 into c values root 3 by 2 into r 2 is how much? 20. This is everything root 3 by 2. This will be 10 power 6. So it become 10 power 4. 10 times it will become 10 power 3. So 10 power 3 divided by root 3 is tan 5. So this is tan phi 1. Can we do any approximation? 1000 divided by 1.732. Let's fold it up. Sorry. Tan phi 2 enna solunga. Tan phi 2 is it not XL divided by R? XL and resonance omega L divided by R. Omega is 100 into L is root 3 by 10 divided by R2, R2 yolo 20, this will get cancelled, 10 and 10 are gone, it is root 3 by 2. Root 3 by 2 tan phi killer. So omega into L, omega 100 into L is root 3 by 10 divided by R1 either. So R1 is 10, then it will be root 3. Upper root either root 3 now. Which implies phi 2 is how much? It is 60 degrees. Guys, it is very complete. Did you guys understand what I did? I'll tell you, I'll draw a phasor diagram and show you what we need to do up here. Guys, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Did you understand what I did?
Actually, yes, sir.
ஒன்னுடா சி இது ரெண்டு சர்க்கியூட்ட உடைச்சிட்டேன் அது புரிஞ்சதா
எஸ் சார்
ஏபி அண்ட் சிடி ஆர் இன் பேரலல் ஐ நோ இட் இஸ் ஸ்லைட்லி டஃப் பட் ட்ரை டு அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் ஏபி அண்ட் சிடி ஆர் இன் பேரலல் கரெக்டா பேரலல் என்ன சேமா இருக்கும்
வோல்டேஜ்
இப்ப சி ஒரு லாஜிக் சொல்றேன் ஐ அம் ஜஸ்ட் டெல்லிங் யூ தி லாஜிக் ஐ அம் யூசிங் டு திங்க் இப்ப ஆர் அண்ட் சி சர்க்கியூட் சீரிஸ்ல இருக்கும்போது What parameter is taken as a reference for you to draw the phasor diagram? When I ask you what parameter, reference is another thing. Whether you are taking voltage as a reference or current as a reference, that is the question. So, you are taking the current here. If you take it as IR, the current across this is also IR. Abhidhan adukkara. Yeah, because they both are in series. Correct, ada? So, if in the V lay and Aguna, VR will get divided here, VC will get divided here. But the only difference is VR plus VC will not be equal to the total voltage. Rather, root of VR square plus root of VC square will be equal to V. Guys, I need to know whether you are able to understand this part. I hope this part is clear, right? This I've taught in drawing a phasor diagram for an RC circuit or RL circuit. Purida illada? Not clear.
Yes, sir. Puri.
Okay. So if I take this as VR, either IR, adhiyan namakku theriyum. Right. So if I call the voltage across the resistor as VR, then the current across the resistor, I'm calling it as IR. Correct. So if I in the IR reference, current through the volt VC will also be IR. This is alternating current. Current through the capacitor will also be IR. Why? Because R and C are in series.
They are in series. Yes.
Correct. So we have to do the reverse analysis. I am trying to draw a phasor diagram which shows the relation between the voltages. So I know if VR is like this, now I will do a reverse calculation by revisiting my capacitor diagram. So capacitor to phasor diagram, if I observe, capacitor phasor diagram observe panna, if I is here, I can put it like this. With respect to I, voltage will lag. With respect to E, current will lead. Puriyuda? It's like active and passive voice. So with respect to current, voltage will lag. With respect to voltage, current will lead. By what factor? By a factor of pi by 2. So, இப்ப இந்த டயக்ராம் பொறுத்த வரைக்கும் வாட் ஷுட் ஹேப்பன் இஃப் மை கரண்ட் இஸ் லைக் திஸ் இஃப் தி கரண்ட் இன் மை கெபாசிட்டர் இஸ் தி ஹாரிசான்டல் டைரக்ஷன் தென் அக்கார்டிங் டு தி ஃபேஸர் டயக்ராம் ஹவு மச் ஷுட் மை பொட்டன்ஷியல் டிஃபரன்ஸ் பி இட் ஷுட் பி VC ஷுட் இட் பி லீடிங் ஆர் லாகிங் வோல்டேஜ் ஷுட் பி லாகிங் அதனால தான VC எப்பவுமே கீழே வரும் இப்ப புரியுதா Guys, I need a response. Am I clear with this? VR and VC, then you take the resultant here, which is V, where V is equal to root of VR square plus VC square. Purida yada? Everybody?
Sir, enakku andha idhu purinjuchu like அந்த டயகிராம் வெச்சிட்டு இது 90 பிளஸ்
இதுவா
சரி எனக்கு அந்த ஃபேஸர் டயகிராம் மட்டும் தான் புரிஞ்சது
புரியுதா
ஆஃப்டர் தி ஃபேஸர் டயகிராம்
இது புரியுதா இல்லையாடா
எஸ் சார் எஸ் சார் அதெல்லாம் புரியுது.
அதுதான் பண்ணேன் நான். இது இது புரிஞ்சதுன்னா ஐ வில் ட்ரை டு ரிலேட் திஸ் டு தி நெக்ஸ்ட் க்வெஸ்சன். ஸோ வென் ஐ ஆஸ்க் யூ டு சால்வ் திஸ் பர்டிகுலர் ப்ராப்ளம், லைக் இஃப் யூ டேக் திஸ் அஸ் அ கான்செப்ட், so rnc we call it as rc series circuit because rnc can be connected in parallel also. Ipa when I call it as an rc series circuit, you know, see rc parallel ungal syllabus la irukku, you only have them to be in series. When you connect them in series, which parameter is taken as the reference to draw the phasor diagram? Are you taking the current as a reference or voltage as a reference? Reference now with respect to that only you will try to define other parameters. So we have to fix something, and with respect to that we will try to vary other parameters. So which value is fixed in this case, in the case of RC series circuit? Is it not current? Because series. In the same way, if I look at this question, what is the change that is happening? I2 இருக்கு பாத்தியா, I2 will be the same across R2 and C, I1 will be the same across R1 and L, but what is common across R2 C and R1 L?
Voltage.
This potential difference. அதனாலதான் what I did is I broke it into two different circuits. I broke it into two different circuits and I tried to calculate what is the phase difference between the voltage and the current in individual circuits. So that what I will do is I will keep the voltage as fixed value, because voltage in this circuit and voltage in this circuit is still fixed. அப்படி இருக்கும்போது then the phase difference between the currents will be what? It is a phase difference that is happening here and here. So another, I found out the individual phase differences. Now I am going to subtract it. That's it. So if 10 power 3 divided by 1.732, it is a very high value. So this is the new concept that you are going to learn. This can be approximated to infinity because it's a very big value. With respect to a triangle, it is a very big value. 1000 divided by 1.732. So up a 5-1 would a value of
90.
5-1 is 90, 5-2 is 60, then what is the answer then?
30.
Purida, it's actually a good problem. I'll suggest you to try something else based on this. Shall I move on to the next one?
Yes, sir.
Fourth. For an RLC circuit driven with voltage of amplitude Vm and frequency omega naught is 1 by root LC, which exhibits resonance, the quality factor is defined as. டைரக்டா ஃபார்முலா இருக்குது
சார். அந்த 1/r இன்டு ஸ்கொயர் ரூட் ஆஃப் L பை C
இல்லடா, டைரக்டா யூ ஐ ஹேவ் எக்ஸ்பிளைன் திஸ் ஃபார்முலா, இட் இஸ் ஒமேகா நாட் L டிவைடட் பை r அவுட் த ஃபார் யூ கேன் ரிமெம்பர் இட் இஸ் ஆக்சுவலி a ஃபார்முலா. Next, we will try out few problems that are based on. See, resonance mathi explain pannirren. Generally, what happens when you connect an RLC circuit is you can actually keep the value of R fixed. The L and C can be varied in such a way that when you keep changing the parameters at one particular instant, the current will be maximum. So the condition where the current is maximum or the impedance is least is what is called as the resonance in AC circuit. So when you talk about a series resonance circuit, when you try to plot the graph between I and F, you will get a graph like this. This is there in your CBSE also. There will be a particular value where the frequency becomes where the current becomes maximum. Right, that current is what is called as that frequency is what is called as resonant frequency. And what is the value of it? Omega naught is given as 1 by root LC, because resonance occurs at XL is equal to XC. Omega naught is this thing, so 2 pi F naught is equal to 1 by root LC. F naught divided by it is 1 by 2 pi into root of LC. So this is resonance frequency. So at resonance, this is the important thing. Impedance is minimum and it is exactly equal to resistance. So sometimes they will say RLC, a series RLC circuit is in such a way that the impedance is equal to resistance. The condition is impedance is equal to resistance. It is a purely resistive. It behaves like a purely resistive circuit. Okay. Similarly, quality factor is 1 by R into root of L by C, or it is omega naught L divided by R also. So omega naught L divided by R. This is also another formula. And the basic definition of quality factor is omega 1 minus omega 2 divided by omega naught. So what is omega 1 minus omega 2? That is a bandwidth. So omega 1 and omega 2 are the frequencies where the corresponding value of the current is 1 by root 2 times its maximum value. So similarly, what is wattless current? The current which consumes no power for its maintenance in the circuit is what is called as wattless current. So this is another important concept you need to know. Transient current is not there in CBSE, so listen to it carefully. So transient current, an electric current which vary for a small finite time, transient na small nartha. Okay. So there are two concepts. What does a capacitor do? A capacitor stores charge. So tell me one thing, as soon as you connect the battery, is the charge on the capacitor going to be maximum? Suppose I give you a capacitor which is going to be empty. You take that capacitor and connect it across a potential source. Do you think the charge on that capacitor will be instantaneously maximum? Will it instantaneously gain this charge Q, or will it take some time to gain that charge?
It will take some time,
right? The time is what is called as the growth phase of the charge which is being stored on the capacitor. That is what an electric current which vary for a small finite time while growing from zero to maximum value or decaying from maximum to zero, means when the charge is completely lost, is what is called as transient current. Okay, please make a note of this. This is not there in CBSE. So I'm directly getting into the concept. If you talk about the concept of growth and decay of current in a device like inductor, then growth of current in an inductor at any instant of time is given by I is equal to I naught into 1 minus e power minus RT divided by L, where this R by L is given an expression called tau, which is called as time constant. So write down this expression. So whenever you see a question that there is a growth of current taking place in an inductor and you are asked to calculate the time constant, then you need to use this expression. I is equal to I naught into 1 minus e power minus RT divided by L. Similarly, okay, you need to know what is the time constant, right? Or you can write it like this. I is equal to I naught into 1 minus e power minus T divided by minus t into tau. Okay, because that RBL is what is called as time constant. So what is the time constant? Time constant in an LR circuit is that value of time that is required where the current grows to exactly 63.2% of the maximum value of the current. Means if the maximum value of current is I naught, there will be a particular point where the current is 0.632. Okay, so the current has to grow from this value to 0.632 times I naught, and this time that is required for the current to grow is what is called as the time constant. Okay, so this is what happens when it is when the current is growing in the circuit, increasing. Similarly, what can happen is decay of current in an inductor at any time is also given by the expression I is equal to I naught into e power minus tau or R into T divided by L. I naught into e power minus R into T divided by L. The time constant of an LR circuit is the time in which the current decays to 36.8 times the maximum value of the current. If you try to subtract these two, you will get 100%. Sorry, add these two, you will get 100%. So if the current is at maximum value, there will be a particular instant where the current is 0.38 times I naught. This time that is required is what is called as the time constant of decay. Okay. So make a note of this. Next. Similarly, charging and discharging of the capacitor. Charging means growth of charge, discharging means decay of charge, means charge is lost. So the instantaneous charge on a capacitor on charging at any instant time t is given by q is equal to q naught into 1 minus e power minus t divided by rc, where this rc is what is called as the time constant in the rc circuit. Okay, similarly, the instantaneous charge on a capacitor in discharging at any instant time t is given by q is equal to q naught into e power minus t divided by rc. This thing. Again, the same concept. So during growth, it is 63.8 times 8% of the maximum value of current. Decay means 36.8% of the maximum charge, sorry. I will explain some problems based on this. If you guys have made a note of it, I will tell you how to solve the problems. Are you ready?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now let's see. So there was a concept, right? LC and LR and LC oscillations. Okay. So consider,
sir, actually what is LC oscillation?
LC oscillation don't know, right? It is actually, you see, communications no chapter and the time line avanukku innum detailed explain pandren ena inge na sonnalo
I sir on chapter irukla sir J
iruk iruk you have for J adanalu solli tharuvanga.
Okay,
appo na solli thara clear appo puriyum. Actually I tell now also it is of no use. Is anyone doing that project? And the investigatory project. Did anyone get an oscillator as investigatory project?
Sir, in the project work, it is not done in physics.
Okay. Or school, school, la pandranga.
Sir, either illa illa inno solla sir inga kitta.
There is no clarity this year. Let's see whatever happens. You keep studying. Okay. Let's see. Consider the LR circuit shown in the figure. If the switch S is closed at T is equal to 0, then the amount of charge that passes through the battery between the time T is equal to 0 and T is equal to L divided by R is how much? So during the process of charging, what is the value of I in an LR circuit? Just now I told you I is equal to I naught into 1 minus e power minus RT divided by L. Correct? Now what are they asking? If the switch is closed, then the amount of charge that passes through the battery. So charge when operating, I should be written as dq divided by dt. This is equal to I naught into 1 minus e power minus RT divided by L. Guys, am I clear with this? So for dq another, it is I naught into 1 minus e power minus RT divided by L times dt. Integrate on both the sides. So when I integrate, so it is 0 to L by R. Here you can take 0 to maximum charge Q. So Q will be equal to I naught is taken out. It will be T minus e power minus RT divided by L divided by minus R by L from 0 to L by R. So I naught into, in the place of T, you will substitute it as L by R minus e power minus R by L into L by R divided by minus R by L. Okay, that is when you substitute L by R minus of 0 substitute panna 0 minus, actually it become plus e power 0, that is 1. So L, this and this will get cancelled. So I naught into L by R plus L by R into e power minus 1 minus 1. This is the total charge. Is there an option like this? What is E? I think the question is incomplete. Soldier.
Sir, like how did we know that நம்ம the current இத apply பண்ணிட்ட அதை வச்சு தான் சார்ஜ் கண்டுபிடிக்க?
Because that is the only thing we know. No, ஒரு ஃபார்முலா தான இருக்கு. See, charge on a direct have it should be a capacitor. அதுக்கு தான் you have the formula Q is equal to Q naught into 1 minus e power minus t by R. So இதுல இந்த பல கெபாசிட்டர் கொடுத்திருந்தா you could have directly used this formula. Whereas with respect to an inductor, I know that only current can be defined. So current வச்சு then I found charge. அதான் லாஜிக், வேற எதுவும் இல்ல. ஐ ஹோப் யூ ரிவ்ட்.
எஸ் சார், எஸ்.
சோ ஐ அம் மிஸ்ஸிங் சம்திங், லெட் மீ சீ, தேர் இஸ் நோ ஆப்ஷன் தட் இஸ் மேட்சிங். ஓ, e பவர் 0 டிவைடட் பை r பை l இஸ் ஆல்சோ தேர், ஐ ஃபர்காட் தட். சோ இட் வில் பீ L by R. So this and this will get cancelled. I naught into L by R into E. What are they calling this ES? Nothing is mentioned in the question. So Q is equal to I naught into L divided by E. Would a value generally 2.7. Irukka 2.7 edavadhu E by R na E na adha enga first of all. Is this E? I think there is a printing mistake. So the potential value here is E. There is a printing mistake. So I naught, if I take it as E divided by R, E into L divided by R square into 2.7. Irukka option adhu mari. EL divided by 2.7 R square irukkada.
Sir, 1 by E oda value 2.7 irukku.
1 by E illa, E oda value than 2.7.
Ah, E, okay.
E is 2.732 approximately. So try out some problem that this concept is completely new to you guys. Kunjo, initially it will be tough only because it demands a bit of math. So there is a coil of self-inductance 10 mH and resistance 0.1 ohm. Is connected through a switch to a battery of internal resistance 0.9 ohm. After the switch is closed, the time taken for the current to attain 80% of the saturation value. Saturation value, no, maximum value. Okay. So what is given? L is given. That is 10 into 10 power minus 3 Henry. Resistance is given 0.1 ohm. Is connected to a switch to a battery of internal resistance 0.9 ohm. After the switch is closed, the time taken for the current to attain 80% of the maximum battery is how much? They told non phi can be considered as 1.6. After the switch is closed, the time taken. So I is equal to, it's again growth. So I is equal to I naught into 1 minus e power minus RT divided by L. Correct? Yes, so what is the value of I they are expecting?
Four by five.
It is 4/5 times I naught is equal to I naught into 1 minus e power minus RT divided by L. This and this will get cancelled. It will be 0.8. So let's leave it like this. 4/5 is equal to up a 1 in the back on this. Now it will become e power.
Sir, e power minus RT minus by L one, will be equal to 1/5.
1/5. Correct? Up a e power RT by L will be equal to 5. Because you take the reciprocal, right? That minus sign will disappear and 5
log
will go
down.
You have to take ln on both the sides. So ln e power RT divided by L is equal to ln 5. So R into T divided by L is equal to 1.6. Ln 5, 1.6. Yeah. R is how much? Resistance is 0.1 ohm and internal resistance is 0.9. Our total resistance was 1 into T divided by L. 10 into 10 power minus 3. 10 into 10 power minus 2 is 1.6. Irka 1.6. So 1.6 into 10 power minus 2, correct?
Yes.
So that is 0.016. That's the answer. Okay. Let's try out the next one. So there is a 20 Henry inductor coil is connected to a 10 ohm resistance in series as shown in the figure. The time at which the rate of dissipation of energy across resistance is equal to the rate at which the magnetic energy is stored in the inductor. The rate at which the rate of dissipation of energy, power. So power is power across, since it's a direct source that is connected. Can I say I square R is equal to the rate at which the magnetic energy is stored in the inductor? What is the energy at which the what is the value? So power stored in inductor is E into I, but E is given as L into di by dt.
Sir, half an I square. Sir.
Either a half.
And the magnetic energy.
Half L A square varadala. Half L A square is the maximum energy stored. There is a particular instant at which the rate of dissipation of energy across the resistance time dependency, it is I square R, is equal to the rate at which the magnetic energy is stored in the inductor at that instant. So I need time.
okay va when the current becomes 100% I not only it is going to be half la square that's what you get when you integrate it okay now we need to find the time epdi kandupidikiradhu what are all the things that are given l is 20 henry resistance is 10 ohm anything else that's it right so this I and that I are the same so I square r so over I poidum so I into r is equal to l into di divided by dt which implies di is equal to di by I is equal to di by I is equal to r by l into dt integrating on both the sides so t is zero the current is also zero the time is to be found at which the current is I seri kandupidikalam ln I is equal to ln I is equal to r by l into t so I will be equal to 1 by r by l into t between 0 to t. Am I missing something? So r by l into t minus u. So I would have value theriyadhu da. So the saturation current, the time of which. Di by dt is equal to r by t. I have to check this one. I need to find out what the value of current is. But are the steps clear?
Sir, avanga magnetic energy nu sonnadhu enna is
rate at which the magnetic energy sorry oma bhasha ki vara magnetic energy half l square correct du by dt anadhu l into I into di by dt that's what I wrote
ah yes
because I use the word rate nanga irka e into I power is rate of doing work is power is v into I so e edathra I wrote into it as l into di by dt I is I only adu puriyudha so the word rate is important here but I'm not sure where I'm getting stuck I is there am I doing some mistake so I if I take it as e divided by r also e divided by r is equal to r by l into t so e avloda e is also not given that is a problem and the answer is in terms of log and one more correction to be done here is ln I cannot take it from 0 to I because if I put 0 here ln I is okay oh this is what I missed Is it dk or?
So I வந்து இப்படி எடுத்துக்கலாமா? I can take it as e power r into t divided by l. I is equal to e divided by r is equal to e power r into t divided by, let's take ln and see, no? Ln of e by r is equal to r into t divided by l. வருதா வருதா ln into e by r na. But how did they get 2? We don't know the value of e, no?
So, ஒரே ஃபாலோ பண்ணுங்க.
சொல்றேன்.
சார், அந்த ஐ ஸ்கொயர் ஆர்டி எங்க சார் எழுதிருக்கீங்க?
I square R. Power. Power is I square R.
இல்ல சார், இது கேட்டேன். அந்த ஜூல்ஸ் லா ஆஃப் ஹீட்டிங் வந்து I square R T தானே சார் வரும்?
இல்லடா, அதுதான் சொல்றேன். You are missing this word rate. What is power?
I square R T by T வருங்கிறீங்களா?
ஆ. So it's I square R. அதுல தப்பு இல்லை, அங்கெங்கேயும் தப்பு இல்லை. Just check the calculation, that is also right only. But I think I'm missing some logic. I irukra adathila, okay, right. Let me write like this and see. Let me give another try, 1 minute. I into L into di by dt, if I call it as I square R. Okay, va? So idu cancel aidum. Appa di by dt is equal to R by L into I. I have to think about this. I'll explain you by next class for sure. பார்த்துட்டு சொல்றேன். Let's not waste time. Let's try another problem based on this. So this one we will discuss later. We'll do some calculation based problems. In a figure shown in the circuit, a circuit contains two identical resistors with resistance 5 ohm and inductance 2 milliampere. An ideal battery of 15 volt is connected in the circuit. What will be the current through the battery long after switch is closed? So resistance is 5 ohm, inductance is 2 into 10 power minus 3 henry, battery's potential difference is 15 volt. What will be the current through the battery after the switch, after long after the switch is closed? So long after the switch is closed, what will happen is, indirectly what they are trying to say is, long after the switch is closed, the current will attain a steady state value. So the inductor is of no use. So if the inductor is of no use, then the circuit will get transformed into a purely resistive circuit. Like R and R are in parallel. But what will be the value of current? I is equal to E divided by R equivalent. E 15, R equivalent is 25 divided by 10. 3, 5, 2 goes up 6.
Sir, doubts.
Tell me.
Sir, if like steady state la vandu like and the inductor la no current is flowing na apuna resistance open eppadi sir inda
edra resistance
illa sir like when namba illa sir steady state na vandu we are supposed to ignore the inductor na inductor capacitor and then we have to ignore la
ஆமா
சார். அப்பனா வந்து லைக் கெபாசிட்டர் வந்து கரண்ட் வந்து 1 ஃப்ளோர்
இல்ல 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 இது தப்பா புரிஞ்சிட்ட. DC சோர்ஸ் இருந்தா இன்டக்டர் இக்னோர் பண்ணனும் நான் சொல்லல. யூ ஷட் இக்னோர் only கெபாசிட்டர். DC சோர்ஸ் இருந்தாலே பை டிஃபால்ட் யூ கேன் இக்னோர் கெபாசிட்டர் ஃபார் கண்டக்ஷன் ஆஃப் கரண்ட். ஃபார் ஸ்டோரிங் ஆஃப் சார்ஜ் எஸ் இட் இஸ் தேர். இட் இஸ் ஸ்டோர் சார்ஜ் பட் இட் நாட் அலோ தி கரண்ட் டு ஃப்ளோ த்ரூ இட். ஓகே, அந்த டைம்ல கெபாசிட்டர் பை டிஃபால்ட் இக்னோர். இந்த க்வெஸ்சன்ல வை ஐ இக்னோர் இன்டக்டன்ஸ் இஸ் பிகாஸ் தே டோல்ட் லாங் ஆஃப்டர் த சுவிட்ச் இஸ் க்ளோஸ்ட். அப்படின்னா தி க்ரோத் இன் த இண்டக்டர் ஹாஸ் ஆல்ரெடி டேக்கன் பிளேஸ் அண்ட் it has got completely, the current in it has completely grown. So it will start offering zero resistance. So it is of no use. It will act like a metallic one. Capacitor will end up with it. It will become an open circuit. Open circuit, closed circuit.
Oh, okay. The resistance here ignore it. No,
resistance is zero. It is infinite. Capacitor, because that's what the concept says. No, XC is equal to 1 by 2 pi into FC. DC porth varaikum XC is infinite ana capacitor is zero provided what condition is achieved? Steady state current illana vandu you have to take the concept of transient current into picture. Puri that difference sir?
Okay sir, okay sir.
Yeah, so we'll try one more while this problem. So let's try the fifth one. So a series AC circuit conducting an inductor, capacitor and resistor is driven by an AC source of voltage 24 volt. Okay, of 24 volt and 50 hertz. The energy dissipated in the circuit in 60 seconds is how much? So energy dissipated in our home, it is energy dissipated na heat I square R into T except the fact that here I will be IRMS. So now it's more in DC, if it is I, that is a steady state current, the equivalent value in AC is nothing but its RMS value. So indirectly what we need to do here is our work is to find out IRMS and then apply the formula. That's it. So how do you find IRMS? IRMS is equal to VRMS divided by Z. VRMS evlo? It is 24. They have given it. 24 divided by Z is root of R square plus XL minus XC the whole square. What else is given? Frequency is given. You can calculate its angular frequency. Capacitance, resistance and inductance is given. Substitute it here. Find the value of IRMS. And take it and substitute it here. That will give you the answer. So again, as I told you, these kind of problems don't touch the exam at the beginning because they waste your time in calculations. You can touch the problems which have only generic values. Okay. I hope the concept is clear. So in the next class, we will try. In the next class, we'll try out few more problems and we'll go to the next chapter. See, electromagnetic waves, there is nothing much to solve. Okay, well, so that part you study, if you need it, we will discuss at the end. Next class, I'll start ray optics. Okay. So, I'll see you guys. You have chemistry, right?
Sir, optics, rendu mudikka mudiyala, sir.
Mudichiruvanna, optics mudichiruvanna. Eppa, unakku exam?
26th, sir. Ana, enak actually konjam romba... அதெல்லாம் வீக்கா இருக்கு சார்.
முடிச்சிரலாம், அது முடிக்கலாம். நீங்க அதுக்குள்ள படிச்சு வச்சுக்கோ, ஏதாவது டவுட்ஸ் இருந்தா
கேளுங்க.
ஓகே சார், ட்ரை மை. ஏனா வேவ் ஆப்டிக்ஸ்ல தேர் இஸ் ஒன் கான்செப்ட் விச் வி டிட் டிஸ்கஸ் அட் ஆல், விச் இஸ் போலரைசேஷன்.
போலரைசேஷன், எஸ் சார்.
அத நான் எக்ஸ்பிளைன் பண்ணனும், அது கொஞ்சம் டைம் ஆகும். ஓகே, அகைன் டிஃப்ராக்ஷன் அட் ஆல் ஐ கேனாட் எக்ஸ்பிளைன் இன் டெப்த். see, since you guys have recording, everybody is physics student here. I suggest you guys to make use of these 2 days and go through all these concepts and so that number problems better up on line, na time will get wasted in discussing the concepts. Sariya padichu, I'll see you guys. I'll see you guys next.
Thank you sir.
Yeah,
thank you sir.
Yeah.